Tesla backup switch is designed to be installed directly behind the customer's utility meter, disconnecting the home from the utility grid during a power outage. If the utility provider does not allow equipment behind the meter, or if the existing meter enclosure is incompatible, backup switch can be installed in a standalone meter panel that is downstream of the utility meter. Whether installing backup switch behind an existing meter or in a secondary enclosure, the process remains the same. Installation of backup switch involves interaction with the home's electrical system and should only be performed by a qualified electrician. Use personal protective equipment that is suitable for interaction with energized electrical equipment. Begin by turning off breakers for any parallel generation sources, then the home loads and main breaker. Please note, even though the home circuits have been turned off and are not under load, wiring from the utility provider may still be live. Meter enclosures come in two main variants: ring type, where the meter is secured to the enclosure with a sealing ring, and ringless, where the meter sits behind the front cover. For ring type meter sockets, remove the sealing ring while wearing cut-resistant gloves. For ringless meter sockets, remove the meter socket enclosure cover. Next, remove the meter from the base. Before installing backup switch behind the utility meter, ensure the meter socket is in good condition and is compatible with backup switch. Note that backup switch can only be installed in Type 2S meter sockets. Inspect the meter to confirm there are no signs of damage, arcs, or misalignment of the blades. Tesla recommends the use of a hot socket gap indicator tester to verify the integrity of the meter socket jaws. If either the meter or meter socket displays damage or is otherwise not in good condition, stop the installation and work with the customer to have the meter socket replaced or install backup switch in a standalone meter panel. Applying an oxide-inhibiting electrical compound to all four meter socket jaws is recommended prior to installing backup switch. Follow the manufacturer's guidance when applying the compound. Align backup switch with the meter socket, and using a rocking motion, plug it into place. Backup switch must be fully inserted to ensure the system is grounded. For ring-type meter sockets, install the sealing ring to secure backup switch to the meter socket. Ensure the sealing ring is oriented so that the front arrow etched into the ring faces toward the meter and not the panel. For ringless meter sockets, install the meter enclosure cover over backup switch. Align the meter blades with the jaws on backup switch and press it firmly into place. Install the sealing ring over the meter. Again, ensure that the sealing ring is oriented so that the front arrow etched into the ring faces toward the meter and not backup switch. If installing backup switch in a secondary meter enclosure, this meter jumper cover is used to provide continuity between the line and load sides of the meter socket. Align the jumper cover blades with the backup switch jaws. Then, push the jumper cover onto backup switch. Install the sealing ring over the cover. Perform a pull test to ensure backup switch feels secure in the meter panel. If backup switch does not feel secure, verify that the sealing rings were installed in the correct orientation. Backup switch is now installed and ready for wiring. A four-wire communication cable connects backup switch to the site controller. From the backup switch accessory bag, retrieve the conduit hub, cable gland connector, and the green connector. Thread the connector into the conduit hub. Run the four-conductor communication cable through the connector and the conduit hub. Remove the outer jacket to expose the four conductors within the cable. Cut the drain wire back flush with the end of the outer jacket. Please note, it is extremely important that the individual conductors are not stripped before termination in the green backup switch connector. When the orange tab is in this position, the wire terminal is closed. Insert a small screwdriver into the rectangular opening and pry the orange tab upward to open the terminal. Insert each conductor into the corresponding terminal until it bottoms out. Then, use a screwdriver to close the orange tab. As the orange tab is closed, the insulation around each wire is pierced, making an electrical connection to the terminal. Perform a slight tug test on each conductor to ensure that they are fully seated in the terminals. Once all four conductors are terminated and tug tested, plug the connector into the bottom of backup switch. Slide the conduit hub over the wiring and connector. Secure the conduit hub to the bottom of backup switch by hand tightening the three included screws. The other end of the communication cable is terminated at the site controller. Please refer to the installation manual and product-specific wiring videos for more details.